And after that, according to places which players are getting, they will go to semi-final. And for example, if the player got the first place, players which got first places in their groups, they will fight in semi-final with each other. And the same for second places. So it means it's extremely important to be the first in the first stage. And it means soon you will play for places from first till fourth. And if to be only second in the group, maximum place that you can reach, it would be only fifth place. So the first stage is very important. And also interesting of this team, of this system, is that players are playing with special new system, not only for Draughts, but for maybe for all sports. System called as Beijing system. What is special in the system is that at first players play normal game with normal time control. They get 1 hour and 30 seconds per each making move. Yes, with Fischer system. And if they have decision in this first game, if someone managed to win this game, so this one gets 12 points and the opponent gets 0. If they will finish the game draw, so they will follow to the next stage of the game. They have to play rapid game. And in a rapid game, they will get already only 20 minutes and plus 5 seconds per each making move. a few not grandmasters, and also of course in this group there is a world champion and also total rating of the group is the highest one. I can describe a little bit players. Alexander Balakin is older one, so he is 51 years old, very experienced player. And his opponent, Jean-Marc Jafang, is 36 years of age. And Alexander Balakin has higher place in the world rating. He is number 6. And Jean-Marc Jafang is only number 32. So we can state that Alexander Balakin is the favorite today. But I can assure you that Jean-Marc Jafang is also very strong opponent, and he has beat before many very strong grandmasters. So I think the pair is equal, and it's 50-50. I mean their chances. Okay, we can see now the time, and Jean-Marc Jafang spent more time. He had more than 11 minutes on the clocks, and Alexander Balakin had an advantage in time, about 5 minutes. Jean-Marc Jafang is two times African champion, really the best player in Africa at that moment. And on the last world championship he took the third place. It's also a very big success for African Draughts. And he left behind many strong grandmasters, world champions. So only one African player before could manage to get so high result. It was Baba C. He at all became the world champion. And at first, when everyone have seen Jean-Marc Jafang and two other players from Cameroon, it was a tournament in Moscow, the World Championship in 2002. And from the first time, almost all African players got very good results. They became grandmasters. So it was big surprise how strong they are. But really in Africa Draughts is very popular. Maybe more popular than other mind games. in many countries, players like to play draughts on the streets, in some cafes, so on the beach. So draughts, it's really popular game in Africa, and so of course it's the first. On the one hand, it's a big surprise that African can play so well, but on the other hand, it's not a big surprise because it's a really national game for them. But the difference is, if compare, for example, with European players, they don't have draft school in Africa. They just playing. They don't have special coaches that preparing children, and they just playing. But it is enough to have so high level for them. So sometimes African style is a little bit different from the European style. They like to make a combination during a game, to play in tactical way. But also many players, as Joe Fang, they take care about positional game, positional play, and you see he develop, for example, this game very evenly, and he feel very well the balance between flanks, how to develop pieces, which field he has to occupy. And still now in this game situation is equal, only difference is with time. Already 10 minutes more has Alexander Balyakin. And Alexander Balyakin is older, as I mentioned before, than Jean-Marc Jofan, but he still is very strong player in blitz. In yesterday blitz tournament, he got the third place. The second place. So, but also it is very special for the African players to play good in blitz stage. So we, as I said before, it's 50-50. And Alexander Balyakin, he's playing now for the Netherlands, but he was born in Russia, in USSR. So he has European style of a game. but unfortunately he couldn't get the world title in 80s, it's middle 80s years, because of another great champion at that time, Alexander Dibban, also from USSR. So Alexander Bolyakin was only second, and in 2005 on the World Championship that took place in the Netherlands, he was third. So of course he has more titles than his opponents. And after he moved to Holland and also became the champion of that country. And the strong part of the Bolyakin's playing is that he can really to play any type of positions. He can surround sometimes giving to the opponent some advantage. The main his aim is to get tension in a game. So he also is enough perfect psychologist. He can feel his opponent, understand what he is afraid. And he doesn't let for the opponent very simple life to the way to escape for draw without struggle. Now I think in this game position for white is, it seems slight better. They control over two central fields, 27-28. Also they support these two pieces with columns. They build some strong construction, you can call us pyramid. And all other pieces of white is close to the main pieces, advanced pieces. So an idea for black is to keep maybe classical type of position. And a few words about Jean-Marc Jouffin. He is not only a strong player, he's also a very good person, very intelligent and open, friendly, outgoing. Now he spent a lot of his time in the Netherlands, because it's really a strong draughts country. You can say traditional draughts country. There are many tournaments there. traditional team competition, and so he's playing there. But he's still representing the country Cameroon. And as I mentioned before, he combined the best from African and European styles. Marjofan made some columns, and so he's written in always with simple combinations, and he confined his opponent a little bit, don't let too much possibilities. And yesterday blitz, Balakin was second and Jean-Marc was took fifth place, so he's also strong blitz player, because I mean that if this game will finish in draw, they have to play blitz game after that, 5 minutes plus 3 seconds for each making move. Of course, all spectators are waiting for the last stage of this match. I mean, Lehmann Georgiev time control, but each opponent wants to decide this game early to win. And in the beginning of our broadcasting, I explained you the rules, and so as you understand, it's extremely important to be the first in the group, because if you are even second, your maximum place which you could get is only fifth. And I think the fighting for the first place will be between Georgiev and Balakin, and also Jean-Marc Jofang. I don't believe so much in Alexei Domchev, but you never know, because Alexei Domchev came to this tournament at the last moment, because young, talented player from the Netherlands refused to play here because of some problems, internal problems, and so in the last moments he was replaced by Alexei Domchev. And you know, in the sport it can bring you some luck when you in the last moment became the participant of the tournament. Jean-Marc Jofan is trying to pressure his opponent. Oh no, they changing pieces. So I think they both not against the draw in the rapid game. And in last year, in the first edition of the World Mind Sport Games here in Beijing, Jean-Marc Jofang took the 5th place. Enough high place. Alexander Barliakin didn't play there. And because he couldn't qualify for the tournament. Yes, we have in Draughts very complex qualification. Players have to play in World Cups, and they're getting points there, and according to the points, they can could qualify to Beijing to the Mind Games. Also, there is some restriction for the players from one country. For example, in Russia they have many strong players, many grandmasters, few world champions, and but they allowed to send only three the best players from Russia. The same situation with the Netherlands. And on the last World Cup, Alexander Barliakin took 4th place. Also so high result. Okay. Not a lot of pieces left on the board, but players are continuing to play. Both of them don't have big weaknesses. So I suppose this game will finish in draw, but you never know. And we cannot see the time. Now we are coming to the end of the game. Jean-Marc Jofang is occupying side fields. Now he moved to field 30. Maybe he wants in future to control two flanks, and if they will get classical type of position, it could be better for him to have control over two sides, because in this case for the opponent could be not enough waiting moves, and the opponent will have to make some bad moves, trying to take out from that closed position. Also here in Beijing we have women tournament. tournament there are 12 players. They're dividing on two groups, A and B, with six players in each one, and they also play an Rabin system. And after that, they have only finals. First place in group A will play against the first place in group B. And the same with other places. Second against second. Third against third. And in women tournament also they had only two results after first normal time control game. So most of the games are continuing in the rapid game, in the tiebreak. You can see clocks, and you see Jean-Marc Jouffin doesn't have enough time, less than 1 minute left on his clocks, and Alexander Balakin has much more, almost 8 minutes, big advantage, but of course position doesn't allow for players so many chances trying to win. But of course still they have some material. And maybe Alexander will find some chances how to complicate the game. Bring troubles for the opponent, because with such shortage of the time, I think Jean-Marc Jouffin cannot dream about possibility to win. Interesting move. 14-20. Jouffin couldn't attack 30-25 before, because after the answer 17-22 the black, they will totally lose. Now black can lock a little bit white right flank. But of course it's not normal log, because three pieces will keep only three, so equal amount. Position is still equal. Alexander Balakin can allow himself to think. He has such possibility. he's threatening with simple combination, trying to win a piece. 1923. Maybe only answer. 38, 33, yes. Now also for black was not so much possibilities. Forcing game. Now Alexander Bolyakin is trying to go to king. But he lost one piece. Of course king is stronger than pieces. Joe Van also wants to go to king. Two white pieces is trying to reach the king row. Yes, players agreed for draw. The game is over. It's draw. Okay, so it means that I will continue this match.
or never
yes,
complain?
Yes, yes. Usually they play faster. But Alexander Balakin is very strong blitz player and also in rapid game.
Okay, so he sees the threat, of course.
Yes. Yeah, they're thinking, but I think it's not good to think so much in the opening because they will not have enough time soon.
Yeah, yeah.
In middle game, in the end game.
But we, the spectators, we are the winners because it promises to be exciting, I think.
Yes. But of course, if you get bad position in the opening, so no good middle game, mm-hmm. and maybe no end game at all. And you see, Alexander Balakin is not hurry to occupy the field 24. He's preparing.
Yeah, he's not in a hurry, yeah?
Yes, he's not in a hurry. Maybe he'll play soon, 33:28.
It's already a full minute difference.
Yes, full minute.
It's a lot.
A lot, yes, for blitz game. But you see, sometimes Jafan can accelerate his playing, and when he will have, for example, 1 minute, he could play very fast and show enough good game.
At some point in time, right now, I think white should go in attack or not, because otherwise black can play 20-24.
Yes, maybe. And after 20-24, position will be more simple, and we will get another kind of position, another type.
But that would not be according to white's.
Yes,
strategy,
yes.
So
yes, I think Balakin's trying to win now because he's not sure that Alexey Domchev will be able to defend in a rapid game against Alexander Georgiev, because Georgiev is the best maybe in the world rapid player.
He needs those points. Yeah.
Yes. And so if Balakin is trying to be the first in this group, he has to win this game. Because if he will win it now, he'll get 9 points. No, only 8 points. Mm-hmm. And in the next time control, it would be only 7 for the winner.
Yeah, and then the difference is not big enough anymore to be certain of the victory in the group. Right?
Yes.
But still, that surprises me that white does not decide to conquer 24.
Maybe they're afraid that that field will be attacked, but they have enough defenses, I don't know.
Yeah, there are, I count 4 black attackers and 4
yes.
white defenders. Eh?
Yes.
Yeah. But of course, that's maybe too simple.
And in this case, also, white could attack the field 23 from the 28.
Of course, yes.
And now you are right that now maybe if he will occupy 24, it's already so late.
It's about time, because
yes.
the black position really is starting to look, well, kind of comfortable.
Yes, they control 22, 23, also side piece.
And it's also showing in the time, eh? He had a 1 minute behind, and already they are
equal. Yes, now it's equal.
Yeah. Things can change fast, also in drafts.
Yes. Alexander Balakin will be preparing the column 41, 37, 32.
Okay, it may be to exchange. Eh? There's yes. there's some force in it. Yeah.
And or to force black to change backward.
Yeah,
but 22, 27.
Yeah, but what you just explained, Yuri, that white has to win this game. This is not a position in which white can think about winning, or is it?
Yes, you are right. But you cannot disregard Jean-Marc Jouffin, because he is also a very strong player. He is dreaming about first place in this group. So,
of course, he's the African champion 2010. Yes. Yeah.
And on the last World Championship, he took third place.
Yeah.
He is maybe the best African player now in the world.
Thinking again.
Yes, he's thinking, and so big difference in time now we have. He's thinking maybe to change backward or to change 22-28. I don't know.
I think it's maybe. I'm really surprised by the amount of time Jean-Marc is investing.
Yes.
I think he should follow his instincts, play faster.
And after this exchange, soon he will try to lock the right white flank.
It's a disaster, the white position, or is this just me?
No, it. But also. Black is thinking, yes. And after the exchange, also white will have the possibility to change maybe 30-24 to develop pieces from the right flank. Because you see now on the left flank, white has only 4 pieces and much more on the right one.
Yes. It's top heavy on the right side. Yes. Yeah.
And Jean-Marc made this strange move for 10 with idea if white would change 32-28, he...
Wow, that white piece there, it's all
yes.
alone.
Yes, all 9 seconds. Big advantage in time for Balakin.
For white, yes.
Yes, for white. Piece looks like in danger, but... So.
It's lonely, but if he manages to hold it,
yes.
It seems like he will be able to. Then
yes,
his dream of winning is coming closer again, I think. Huh?
Yes, but in Draughts there are a lot of draw possibilities, so cannot be sure about winning. It's too early telling about winning. Also, this column. 34, 40, 45. Don't let black come closer to the piece 23.
Mm-hmm.
For example, cannot play 10, 14.
It's all different kinds of combinations.
Yes, simple combination. But of course, Jean-Marc cannot miss such a simple combination.
Six seconds,
yes. No interesting situation, because the piece 23 could be in danger.
Yeah.
So, yes.
But time-wise, it is black who is balancing on the edge, huh?
Yes. Now.
Often when you are in an advantageous position, you have little time, the temptation can be big to invest too much time to find a concrete variant that wins.
And now Balakin managed to defend the piece on 23. Now it's not only one piece. He has also piece on 24. So his position look like very strong.
Yeah, but now Black makes a new formation.
Mm.
Oh yeah, but it's going nowhere, of course. Yes. The white defense is okay.
Now sacrifice.
That's a nasty piece there at 13.
One piece more for white, but Jean-Marc is trying to break through on the he's
on the right side of white.
Yes,
It looks as if
he managed to do it. Now two pieces more for white and they have to give one. Now impossible to make king immediately.
Yeah, because then the king immediately gets killed. Huh?
Yes. 26 seconds for Balakin and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
He is really a master of suspense.
Yeah.
Incredible.
It looks like he likes such situations because not only now, but
he performs maybe well under pressure.
Maybe.
I think Balakin forgot to crown his king.
Maybe.
Yeah. He simply does not have the time. He does not permit himself the time to crown it.
Okay, two pieces more in this endgame. It's already endgame because we have kings. Yes. Oh, small combination.
Yeah. So now only one piece difference, and Black has got the main diagonal.
Yes.
So Black is the minority position. Can he still make a draw, you think? Or the black pieces are very endangered, I think. Huh? They are standing in the middle of the board.
No, he's trying to change.
Okay,
the game is over, and so stay on. See you in the next